Hello, my name is Catherine Sansing, and this is my video presentation of Erik Erikson. Erik Erikson was a German philosopher. He was most notably known for him being one of the founders of the ego theory. While most of his work was in psychology, he did make quite a few notable theories to forward education and educational theory. And this mostly comes from his stages of personal and social development. Now, in those five stages, he outlined at what stage developmentally children were. It's five stages, and they are listed by age. And some say that they can be stretched out through lifelong stages, but his gives a timeline, a time period of when he believes that this would occur. And so the first stage is called trust versus mistrust. It's from birth to 18 months. Second stage is called autonomy versus doubt. It is from 18 months to 3 years old. The third stage is initiative versus guilt. And that is from ages 3 to 6 years old. The fourth stage is industry versus inferiority. That is from age 6 to 12 years old. And stage 5 is identity versus role confusion. That is from 12 to 18 years old. And like I said, that can be stretched out to even longer. This is kind of just a rough basis of what he believed. And the first stage is like infancy and then learning to trust their primary caregivers, like their parents or anything like that. It's satisfying the need for food or attention or affection, anything like that. Stage 2 is what they call the terrible twos, and they're learning, you know, they're learning their senses, they're learning to walk, they're learning, you know, everything around them. They're becoming a little bit more independent, and they are, you know, becoming their own person at first. Stage 3 is they're continually maturing, and they're focusing more on their motor skills and their language skills, and they are exploring more, and they are becoming more physical. They're playing more. They're being kids. And so the next stage would be industry versus inferiority. That is, you know, 6 years old to preteen years, where they're entering a more school-aged, and school is becoming a lot more serious, and they are expanding. It expands into their social life and their friends and becoming more dependent on teachers. And then the last stage is where the kids are becoming more adults. They're teenagers and, you know, moving on in age, and they're trying to find themselves, and they're finding out their own values or their morals or what they believe in themselves. And so I think these are very important as far as teachers, because it shows where they are. And if you're teaching someone who is 13 and they're becoming teenagers and they're focused on other things, you can more so develop lessons that will keep them interested. Like, you can't gear one lesson towards a 10-year-old that wouldn't work for a 16-year-old as well. Well, you're making them where they're more interested, and I think it helps with, if you're learning it and you're looking at a 10-year-old who is in the fourth stage, and they're more focused on school, and they're seeing, you know, their peers. You see a model in your teacher, and you want to please your teacher, and so using words of affirmation or encouraging and motivating those students will work a whole lot more than disciplining them or making them feel guilty. You know, it does more developmentally for them. And so these five stages outline what helps them developmentally and how you can gear your lessons towards helping them in their right state of mind. And so the critiques and challenges of what I've seen is other people critique him, and there is one that I have seen, and it comes from the author of Coal and Coal. That's what it says. And they complain that this theory is more geared towards male students than it is female. You know, it does not work for both sides, and that can come in the period of developmentally where girls are, because they do say the brain, the male brain does develop slower than females, and so it this theory doesn't necessarily have everyone in mind when it's talking about girls and boys. But I believe that my own critique, I see that what I take most out of it is just the where is best to help. You know, what is more helpful when you are dealing with your students, because it does give the motivations and challenges in each portion of the stages. And so I think that it's more beneficial when it helps knowing your students are at this age, and treating them this way will help them most. And while it does not work for every student, this is just the basis of what they say, or what he says is what is most needed at that time. But in my critique, I do believe that it's most beneficial to listen to these stages, because I really do agree that knowing where they are mentally, as far as ages goes, helps gear lessons towards where they are in their minds. And yep.